arms are not held by the Guard of Honor, but they soon will be. They're the only arms on show here at the muster, and soon Her Majesty will arrive. The Drumhead altar is prepared, and the Drumhead service will follow. Drums of the Royal Marine Band. It was constructed by the buglers and musicians from the band. Four drums, one bass drum, one tenor drum, arranged on top of each other. And the Corps Drum Major, Royal Marines Warrant Officer James Whitwam, MBE, will be, has directed the build. And here comes the Queen. Salute played by the state trumpeters of the Household Cavalry, drawn from the bands of two units that make up the Household Cavalry, the Life Guards and the Blues and Royals. The Queen escorted to her seat by the Chief of the General Staff, General Chief of the Defence Staff, General Sir David Richards. And during the first hymn, All People That on Earth Do Dwell, the colours of each service will be draped over the drums.
Together to praise God and to acknowledge with gratitude the 60 years of faithful service to this nation of our Sovereign Lady Queen Elizabeth. With respect and affection, we give thanks for the example she has set her people, and we pray that, supported by the love and loyalty of her subjects, she may be given health and strength to continue her service and long to reign over us.
Reverend Scott Brown, Chaplain of the Fleet. Service will be draped over the drums by the service chaplains.
Thank you. reading from the Gospel of St. Matthew. Then the mother of the sons of Zebedee came to him with her sons, and kneeling before him, she asked a favor of him. And he said to her, "What do you want?" She said to him, "Declare that these two sons of mine will sit, one at your right hand and one at your left in your kingdom." But Jesus answered, "You do not know what you are asking. Are you able to drink the cup that I'm about to drink?" They said to him, "We are able." He said to them, "You will indeed drink my cup, but to sit at my right hand and at my left, this is not mine to grant, but it is for those for whom it has been prepared by my Father." When the ten heard this, they were angry with the two brothers. But Jesus called them to him and said, "You know that the rulers of the Gentiles lord it over them, and their great ones are tyrants over them. It will not be so among you. But whoever wishes to be great among you must be your servant, and whoever wishes to be first among you must be your slave. Just as the Son of Man came not to be served, but to serve, and to give his life a ransom for many." Let us pray as we say together, "Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, for ever and ever. Amen." God of time and eternity, whose Son reigns as servant, not master, we give you thanks and praise that you have blessed this nation, the realms and territories, with Elizabeth, our beloved and glorious Queen. In this year of Jubilee, grant her your gifts of love and joy and peace, as she continues in faithful obedience to you, her Lord and God, and in devoted service to her lands and peoples, and those of the Commonwealth, now and all the days of her life, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen.
That this time of Jubilee, Thanksgiving, may also be a time of dedication, let us say together, Lord of our lives, and Father of all, grant that our thanksgiving may prove itself in service to you and to our Queen, to our country and to one another, for your name's sake. Amen.